Sometimes you can see it coming a mile away, and sometimes it happens when you least expect it. Your professor attacks your faith. Maybe you're taking a New Testament class in college and you think it's going to be hunky-dory reading about Jesus in the New Testament and the letters of St. Paul. Or maybe you're taking a class in sociology and you kind of have an idea from the title of the books that they're going to portray your Catholic faith as being homophobic or transphobic or something like that. But what do you do when a professor attacks your faith? When a professor attacks your faith, it's often a difficult decision of how to respond. The professor is in a position of power and authority over you. They are the ones assigning your grade. You fear that if you disagree with them, if you speak up for your faith, that they're going to, in some way, punish you for it by your grade. And honestly, of course, the grades, the GPA, are often why we come to college, to get the degree, to get the job, so we can have a life and a future. So therefore, if I argue with this professor, then my entire future is up in smoke. So what am I going to do? Relax. When your faith is attacked in class, there are responses you can make and ways you can go about answering it. Here's a couple ideas for you. Number one, when a professor attacks your faith, maybe just makes a blanket statement, all Catholics are homophobic, ask them for a citation, ask them for a reference, ask them for a source for their claim. If you made a claim in class or in a paper, professors would ask you for a source, am I right? So turnabout is fair play. What often happens when people make a claim like that, they are misreading or maybe they're ignorant about some detail the church is teaching. So it's good to have them give you a source, give you a citation. It's fair to ask for that. You could even ask it in a non-confrontational way. Oh, yes, Professor McGillicuddy, that's an interesting theory. Where could I read more about that? What's your source for that? All Catholic teaching, of course, is public knowledge. There's no secret teachings of the church. So you can find and know what your professor is sourcing, and then you can know how to defend it and explain the faith to them. The second thing you can do is that you can bring your questions, bring their questions from class, to me, to another priest, to some Catholic you trust who has a deep knowledge of the faith, and look for answers. But don't just look for a quick and easy answer. Look for a good response. Look for an intelligent response. This is a great time to discover one of the beauties of our faith, that our faith is very reasonable. Yes, our faith is revealed by God, but this faith is not contrary to human reason. Our faith is reasonable. I believe it's Bishop Barron who uses the phrase, it's suprarational, meaning it's above reason. It isn't irrational, meaning opposed to reason. Rather, it's with reason, but above it as well. So our faith is in accord with reason in that way. The third thing to look out for is the straw man arguments. Oftentimes, when you talk with someone about your faith, they're going to be opposing it in terms of straw man arguments, which means they're going to reduce the faith to the simplest form possible. Oh, Catholics say this, so therefore that. They're going to try to make your arguments, make the defense of the faith in its least robust form. Now, when we're making arguments, we always want to use the best form of the argument the opponent has. There's a great saint who would do that quite often, St. Thomas Aquinas, who would list all the objections to this or that point of faith and then answer those objections clearly, giving his opponents the best shot possible to disprove what he was trying to prove, which is something we do when we're confident in the truth and confident in our Lord. Professors attacking your faith can be a scary thing, but it can be a great growing moment for your faith. Know that our Lord hasn't left you alone in those moments, and know that the Catholic Church has wisdom that goes back many years. And many of the questions that professors propose to you may seem like they're new, but they're not, and there's answers to be found already waiting for you. God bless you. Have a great week.